Clouded leopards are majestic wildcats, perfectly adapted to traversing the dense forest of Asia. But as with many species, their systems are under enormous pressure. Come with me to the forest of Asia and let's see how researchers are trying to understand these species better and conserve them for the long term. I'm Chrishen Gomez from the WildCRU, and I'm particularly interested in understanding human-modified landscapes and how that affects carnivore connectivity. Particularly how we can see that from underlying genetic structures of these populations. Across many wild landscapes, ecosystems are under pressure. Small pockets of land are being converted for human activity, resulting in fragmenting what was once rich and diverse habitat or intact ecosystems. This has prevented dispersal from happening between these habitats. Many mammals are becoming very cautious in their dispersal because of the poorly connected habitats, resulting in reduced fertility driven by the pernicious force of inbreeding depression. But the key question remains, is this happening on Borneo too? Over the last 3 years, I, alongside an incredible team, have spent months tracking through the forest of Borneo, working with colleagues from the State Park Authority, Sabah Parks, to add satellite tracking collars to Sunda clouded leopards and collect as much associated data, such as genomes, as possible. Collaring any animal is an enormously difficult exercise, but collaring an animal that hardly anyone ever sees is nearly impossible. It takes months for a team of 5 to 6 people with lots of equipment and pretty advanced remote monitoring equipment to deploy a single collar on a single animal. The satellite trackers we deploy in clouded leopards are designed specifically for them so as to minimize any disturbance we might have on their daily activities. After the deployment, we scrutinize every piece of data we get from the field to make sure that there are no abnormalities to their daily life. At this point, you might rightfully wonder why all of this investment of time and effort is worthwhile at all. But the answer, thankfully, is blindingly simple. Following these animals not only teach us so much about clouded leopard conservation efforts, but they also help us unveil a mystery to a much more complex question, and that is the relationship between forest and biodiversity as a whole. Borneo is a crucial place for studying biodiversity simply because there's just so much of it. The models we generate from tracking clouded leopards tell us so much about the habitat types that are needed to maintain what we think is an intact ecosystem for biodiversity as a whole. Creating a place that's not just for large predators to roam free, but also for the many, many species of birds, butterflies, beetles, amphibians, reptiles, and small mammals that all equally call Bornean rainforest their home.